Welcome to Google Developers Weekly for September 16, 2013. I'm Lewis Gray, and this is our highlight reel of what's happening in the world of Google developers on the set and off. While the weather here in sunny Mountain View has been pleasant, our GDL studios were dominated by clouds last week. Google's cloud platform team delivered four separate videos for you Cumulus and Stratus aficionados, starting first with the core benefits of the platform, including rapid compute scaling and large-scale data analytics. The video series also includes case studies from companies like Rovio and Shutterfly, letting us hear how they can easily deploy what would otherwise be a complex infrastructure and reduce latency while scaling to meet spikes in user demand. Google's mission is to make the world's information universally accessible and useful. That includes making content on the web accessible to blind and low vision users. Internet pioneer Vint Cerf, TV Ramen, and others from Google's accessibility team join us in the GDL studio to kick off the Web Accessibility MOOC. And as promised last week, the BigQuery duo of Felipe Hoffa and Michael Manucciari introduced us to correlation, turning data and assumptions into actionable information. From Tel Aviv, Ido Green delivered a two-part series on how to build a mobile application using Google Docs and AppScript as the back end. And by the way, it's also a very cool example of bidirectional tech support in an application. Heading back to Cloudville, Jarek Vikevich and Fred Sauer showed us how to get started with the YouTube API using the Cloud Playground. While from Buenos Aires, Nick Bortolotti discussed cloud endpoints. From our Tokyo studio, Eiji Kitamura continued his focus on web audio, diving into the MIDI API for more pure sound in your browser. Here back in Mountain View, Google Analytics' Jim Contuno and Andrew Wales went behind the code to give us an inside look at what's new in the recently released Google Analytics version 3 mobile SDK. When it comes to counting clicks on any device, real time is the best time. Wrapping our studio activity for the week was Paul Saxman, who introduced a brand new show, Maps the Mobile Experience. This week, Paul explored techniques for building a single-handed smartphone interface for browsing a collection of photos on a map. Oh yes, more cloud. We're taking it on the road. Registration is now open for the Google Cloud Platform Developer Tour. Later this month and next, we'll be visiting Tokyo, London, Berlin, Paris, and Tel Aviv for in-depth talks on App Engine, Compute Engine, and Platform Services. Come see us if you're going to be in our neighborhood. And you've probably heard of Raspberry Pi, a small, inexpensive device that's great for learning how computing works. We love Raspberry Pi. And now we've built Coder, a project that turns your Pi into a web server and development environment. Take a look at our project page and get started with Coder, and get all the kids you know involved too. To make sure you never miss a thing from the world of Google developers, subscribe to Google Developers on YouTube and check out the GDL schedule at developers.google.com/live. I'm Lewis Gray, and I'll see you in the studio.